So this machine is my, well, I was gonna say my kid's, but it's really mine. It's just he's kind of adopted it. It is my Dell XPS, what model is it? 8300. It's a big desktop. It was meant to be kind of a gaming desktop. I had it for a year or so, and then my kids kind of took it over when I switched mainly to my laptop. And I had Windows 7 Pro on it, and my kid has been riding my ass to install Windows 10. So what I'm gonna do really quick is I'm gonna keep the hard drive that's in there. It's getting kind of full, but my plan is to keep the hard drive, just pull it aside just in case I need it, and then what I'll do is I'll put in the spare hard drive I have. This little guy, what is this? I think this is a 250 gig. That's an old hard drive, 2010. Yeah, I think it's a 250 gig, 7200 RPM drive. So it's nothing too special, but it will fit his needs. And then I'm going to install Windows 10 on it, which I just lost the operating system disk. Hopefully I didn't scratch it. And that's it. So we're going to pull up this drive, put in that drive, and then we'll load the OS. So I guess the first part to start with is figuring out which drive is C and which drive is D. The C drive is your operating system drive, and D drive I keep separate to use for documents. And I do that, well, just to be safe mainly. In case I have to do backups or anything, and or if a hard drive fails, I like to keep my data separate than I do from everything else. So I'm gonna pull out this caddy part here. And what I'm gonna do is I'll take a look to see which drive is which. This is a, I don't know if it's an i5 or an i7 third gen. It's got a little video card in it. I think it has 16 gigs of RAM or 8 gigs of RAM. Maybe those are 2 gigs each. It's been so long since I've even used this thing, so rule number one when you're doing anything, ground yourself. You do not want a little tiny shock to kind of kibosh your entire day. That drive isn't in there very tight. Okay, that's your power, by the way. That's called SATA. This little part here does the data. So power, data. Now, which drive is this? This is a Seagate 1 terabyte 7200. I don't know if that's the D or the C. Now, what's cool with the screwdriver is that it bends. Isn't that cool? That is worth every penny. Well, I would say it's worth every penny, but they're pricey. It's like a $30 screwdriver. I think they might have been both 1 terabyte drives. 1 terabyte. Shit, I don't know which one is which. Huh, well, let's pull them both out, I guess, and then I'll figure out later which one is which. So now I'm going to put a drive in here. Basically, I got data on both those 1 terabyte drives, so. So we'll just use the one drive for now. You really want your hard drive screwed in tightly because this is the last thing you want vibrating inside that machine. So when the power supply and your CPU fan and your exhaust fan and even the CD drive get flipping really fast, they're going to cause little vibrations inside the PC. And that will shake the hard drive. And if the hard drive, basically, it's a bunch of little platters connected with what looks like a record player needle. and you do not want it to start vibrating. Okay, so that's pretty tight. You can see they're numbered. One, two, three, four. That's supposed to be the order you tighten them in, but really it doesn't really make much of a difference. So let's assume that this was C. We shall tuck this away down here. I should have labeled these. If that is C, I will then relabel this in C. Say to zero. Yeah, that's C. Because I'm going to flip this around here in a second anyway, but... I don't know if you can read the writing on here, where the tip of this is, SATA 0, SATA 1, 0, that's this guy, 0 is going to be your C drive, SATA 1, that's this guy, it's going to go to the CD drive. And then on the other side over here, we have 3 and 2, and they'll go to other data points. Okay, let me plug this thing in, throw in the operating disk or the operating system. I'll run through the Windows 10 install. I'm using the Windows 7 Pro license that I have, and that should get it up and running for him. Oh, 16 gigs of RAM. Okay. Let's see what happens. My kid's desk is more of a mess than mine. Let me put this camera on a tripod to make it a little bit easier.
A few moments later.
Dun dun dun. Windows 10. Pick your language. Good to go. Install now. I hope there's nothing on that hard drive, but I don't really care, to be honest. If I haven't accessed it in this long, then who knows what's on it. Okay. Now, what really bothers me is it does have a Windows 8 license embedded in the firmware, but I can't get to it. Oh, I guess that was the right license. So what I did there was I deleted the partitions that were on there from before, so that just wiped out any kind of data that was on there. So I'm going to choose drive 0 unallocated space, 230 gigs, and hope that's enough for him. Okay, while it's doing that, I have to go check my mail. Okay, that's basically it. It's kind of boring from here on in. I'll turn this back on in a second. Okay, so everything looks handy and dandy. Now, the part I really hate is setting up the email or logging in with a Microsoft account and stuff because my kid doesn't have one. And what I also do is a lot of times, instead of backing up the computer before I start doing this, I just pull the drives out, and then I carry one of these guys. This is a USB 3.0 SATA drive connector. And then as I need the data, I'll just pull it over. But that is it. I mean, in a nutshell, it's really that easy to change a hard drive and install an operating system in a desktop. And I'm really making this video for Laura. So Laura, if you're watching, that's how you do it. All right, so good luck. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. I do appreciate you watching. Please subscribe, and we shall talk again shortly. Enjoy your day. Enjoy your weekend. We'll talk soon.